Hello children, good morning. Children, today I am going to explain your EVS lesson 2. Okay? You might be thinking that this teacher, our art teacher will be taking only Hindi and English, and why she is taking EVS today. So the thing was like Kaushal teacher got busy with some other work, that's the reason I am explaining here. Only for one lesson, okay? Don't take me granted. So, challenges answer. Children, we see many people around us. Mostly all of them are same like us. They can walk like us, they can talk like us, they can read, they can eat, everything. Okay, but some people are blind, some people are deaf, some people are physically handicapped. That means they cannot walk properly, or some people will be having the ability to, they will not be having one or the, some of the people will not be having two hands, or some people will be having only one hand. With one hand they will be doing all their things. Okay, these kind of people are known as special people. Okay children, because they are made in the special way. Because see, when we see a blind man, though he is blind, he cannot see anything with his eyes, he can understand by listening and by sensing. Well, see, this is the nature, this is the creation of God. When God made us with the with one sense organ, he had taken our one sense organ, remaining other senses he will make it strong. That means the person who cannot see with his eyes but can understand by listening or by smelling or with his brain, by sensing it, okay, by touching also he can understand. By like touching an ice cream, we can say without seeing also, if we are touching some cold thing, we can say it, right? You can also practice these things normally as a practice to make your senses much strong. You can tie a blindfold in your home only, children. Don't do these all things outside. When we blindfold ourselves, that means when we are covering our eyes with one cloth or one napkin or one with the paper, like anything, we by closing our eyes, okay, nothing we can see. If we close our eyes, we cannot see anything, right? But we can sense that air, we can sense the air around us, right? We can sense if someone is walking in our room, wherever we are sitting. We can sense the heat or cold. If we are touching something very chilled item, we can feel that it is a cold thing. Or if we are touching any hot cup of tea, hot cup of milk, we can understand, right? By touching its surface, we can understand whether it is hot or cold. So, other people who are differently challenged people, the special people who do not have some particular organ, the physical organ, or particular part in their body, but their brains will be sharp enough to understand it with some other parts. Okay, some people are even blind, even they are deaf. Some people are blind, deaf and dumb. That means they cannot hear, they cannot talk, they cannot see. Even though they are smart enough. Smart enough means they use only their brain. So these people are special. Okay, so because they are using their brain. We have everything, sometimes we'll do some foolish things. Though we have our eyes, though we have our nose, though we have our mouth, though we have our ears, after having so many senses also, we'll do some stupid things unknowingly or wantedly we'll be doing. See, small children, though they know everything, but what, for fun's sake they'll do, or sometimes they'll do for unknowingly. Like they are innocent, right? Small children, they doesn't know what is correct and what is wrong, they doesn't know. So unknowingly they will be doing. So these special, we are going to read about these special people in our lesson. And challenges, answer. Take out your English, textbook, page number 114, okay? What is the page number? 114. Challenges, answer. Can you see, hear, smell, taste and feel? If your answer is yes, have you ever thought about those around you who cannot do these things? So, have you thought anytime? So, the people who cannot hear, who cannot talk, or who cannot smell, who cannot see. Have you heard about these people? How do they be they will be running their life, they will be taking care of themselves and other people? How? Will be reading. Differently abled people are those who are unable to use one or more of these senses. Okay? Usually, we all have five senses: eyes, sense of seeing, eyes, sense of smelling, nose, sense of taste, our tongue, sense of hearing, our ears, sense of touch is our skin. Our skin has the sense of touch. When we touch the like smooth surface, we'll feel it. It's a very smooth thing. If we are touching any rough surface, like a ball or anything, rough surface, we'll be feeling immediately it is very rough. So this is the sense of touch. And apart from five senses, we have one another sense, that is our sixth sense. That means our brain. Okay, with our brain we can understand something is going on, some good thing is going to come or some bad thing is going to happen. This is acted according to our brain. Okay children, so the people who are blind and cannot see but they can see, differently able people are those who are unable to use one or more of their senses, one or more of their senses. When one of the senses get impaired, that means when it becomes completely impairment, stops working. Impairing means what? Completely stop working. So the other senses become sharper to make for it. So if they are losing their eyes, okay, if any of guys are, they cannot see anything because they are blind, okay, but they can sense with what? With smell, with touch, by hearing or by sensing with the brain. Okay, these all will become stronger because here it is, here we are, the people who doesn't who are unable to see, who are blind, that sense completely gone, right? So that energy, whatever they are putting on seeing anything which they are not using, they are utilizing that energy to do another things. That means, as I told you, to hear, to taste or to smell or to understand. Okay, now people who are blind cannot see but they can easily recognize things or people with the smell or the feeling of touch because their senses of smell and touch are very strong. Okay, the people who cannot see but they are strong enough to understand the things by touching or by feeling. Now, as we have learned in our earlier class, blind people use braille script to read and write. Okay, blind people, what they'll use, they'll be having some braille script. Children, by touching they can understand this is A, this is B. Okay, there is a braille script. I think Usha teacher have already explained to you. Okay, now people who are deaf, people who are deaf and dumb use sign language to communicate. The people who cannot talk, okay, and who cannot see, they will communicate or they will tell other people whatever they wanted to tell in the sign language. That means by action they will say or by they will be writing and showing. Okay, they will be having some brain, I mean different kind of script. By touching they can understand this is this, this is this. Now nowadays lifts have braille symbols so that the blind can know the floor numbers and the direction arrows. So in the lift, whenever we take the lift, we'll be having their numbers, right? 0, G, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever, how many ever floors of building is, we'll be having them. If the blind person gets into the lift, how we can, that is also a braille print is printed on the buttons of the lift. Have you seen, when we touch, we can feel the arrow, we can feel the number 2 or we can feel number 1. Okay children, that is a braille script which we can feel the things, the digits or the letters by touching, which we can feel, that is known as a braille system. Okay, they are little bit raised from the surface. Okay, they are not completely printed, they are completely, I mean by touching also we can feel it. Care for differently abled people. So how can we care them? See, the differently abled people who doesn't have eyes, who doesn't can hear, who doesn't can talk, they need our help and they need our care. They don't need some sympathy, how it happened, why you went that, I mean why you went there or why you did that. These all sympathy words they don't need. They need only our empathy. Empathy means our care towards them. Okay, caring is simple. Caring is empathy and feeling sorrow and detecting telling them all these things are sympathy. We should be kind towards a differently abled people. That means we have to be very kind and friendly to the differently abled people. They need our empathy, not sympathy. As I told you all, they need our care, not our telling them some kind of slogans, don't do that, don't do this. Instead of telling all this, you care them. That is more than enough. Because we are human beings, right? So we should be helpful to them. Our government has recognized this need and has provided certain facilities for such people. Not only normal people, children, government also have provided some different schemes to differently abled people. Many schools and colleges have been set up across the country for children who are differently abled. So many organization has been working to help these kind of people. Special computers with the speakers for visually challenged students have been set up. Okay, special computers. So the people who cannot see, for them special computers, so that only they can listen and they can understand what is going on. So that kind of computers are also made. News for people who cannot hear is telecast by the national channel in sign language so that they can understand. So the people who cannot hear, who are deaf, for them news also will come in the sign language. Have you seen? I think many of them guys, you know what is in the sign language also, there will be like showing the news. The reporters, I mean the news readers, one side the news will be read by one guy, and here one woman or another news reader, she will be or he will be acting whatever that guy is telling to this guy. Like they will be using C, D, this type of sometimes sign languages that we use. Now ramps are made at railway stations, metro stations, shopping malls and many other places for many other public places for people who are physically disabled and have to use the wheelchairs. Means not only in the normally normal places, not only in their homes, in the special like shopping malls, okay, cinema theatres, in the hospitals, ramps are made. Ramps means a slope area, okay, where wheelchair can be carried easily from down to up and up to down. That is known as a ramp without any speed breaker. Ramp, completely plain surface. Okay, children, I think you guys have seen in hospitals they will be taking the patient, making them sit on the wheelchair and they will be taking them directly. Okay, that is a ramp. Now, in public places like restaurants and libraries, doorways have been enlarged to accommodate wheelchair. So in libraries and restaurants also, the doors are, the main gates are little big so that they can take the wheelchair. Okay, we are giving them all the necessary happiness whatever they want, because we cannot say this place is only for the good people who can hear, who can dance, who can talk, who can do many things like us. Like, yes or no? Because the country, the place and the happiness is for everyone. Everyone can enjoy. Though they can talk, though they can see or they cannot see, though they can hear or they cannot hear, these people also have the complete right to enjoy the life according to them. Right, children? So other places also have organized such different kinds of initiatives they have taken, different kinds of steps they have taken to provide the complete happiness to the people, different abled people. Now, listening devices and braille signboards have been installed. So listening device, the people who cannot see, for them listening devices like headphones they are providing so that they can listen and they can understand what is going on. And braille also, that means they can touch the things and understand what is written over there. Now see here, fact zone. Fatehpur Sikri is a monument in Agra. Okay, Fatehpur Sikri is a monument situated in Agra that has provisions like ramp. There also they have ramp so that wheelchairs can be carried easily, braille signboard, special toilets, ticket counters and a defined route and dedicated parking for the differently abled people. So see children, these guys, the Fatehpur Sikri, the management also have taken the initiative. They also have provided many facilities to the differently abled people. Now learning with difference. Okay, so everyone have the right to education, whether you are blind, whether you are deaf or whether you are perfectly okay. That is your wish. If you want to get the education, you can get, because it's your fundamental right. You can directly achieve knowledge if you wanted to. If you are interested in going to school, you can at any age, you can join school at any age, you can join the college. Okay, there are some age factors with criteria in that we need to select and we can join. Okay, the people who cannot go to school, for them home tuitions are arranged. That means the teacher, interested teacher, can go directly to that person's home and she or he can teach that particular student at whatever age. If you are interested, they will be coming and teaching you. So Helen Adams Keller, okay, one of the women. Helen Keller was an American author, political activist, and lecturer. See children, this lady was author. Author means what? A writer, political activist, and lecturer. Lecturer means a teacher in the college. She was the first deaf-blind person to earn a Bachelor of Arts degree. She became deaf-blind when she was only 19 months old. That means 19 months old baby, she will be very small, 1.5 years, okay? 1 year will be having 12 months, right? So 9 plus 12 months plus how many? 7 months. How many it will become? 19 months. That means almost 1.5 year baby. When she was about 1.5 year age, she became blind as well as deaf. Though she was blind and deaf, she have achieved her bachelor's degree. That means what? Completing one degree level after inter college.